Don't be all butthurt!
It seems like with every major GTA that's about to be released, there's bound to be people trying to pass off obviously fake information, images, or video as real. We saw it with GTA 4, like how I talked about in my last video on this topic. People in the comments even reminded me of this Coca-Cola commercial that was from early 2007, clearly inspired by GTA, but there were some people trying to pass this off as actual footage of GTA 4. And guess what? Now it's evidently footage of GTA 6. Because, you know, who can't wait to drag a guy out of a car and then give him a soda for his troubles? And then, in the period between 2010 to 2013, from before GTA 5 was announced right up to its release, we saw a repeat of the same thing. Minus people trying to pass soda commercials off as in-game footage, but that doesn't mean that they didn't try saying that footage of other games was actually GTA 5. Before we get to that though, let's go in chronological order from how I remember these. Before GTA 5 was officially revealed in 2011, nobody was really certain where the game was going to be set. Some people correctly speculated that it was going to be somewhere in San Andreas, although others thought of different locations such as Chicago, London, and Wisconsin, because why not? But I think the one location that everyone figured it would be in, myself included, was Vice City. Of course, we were all wrong, but until a few seconds passed after the first trailer was revealed, because let's face it, this kinda does look like it could be Vice City, we really had no idea where the game was gonna be set. Therefore, some of the earliest batches of fake screenshots were based around the idea that GTA 5 would be set in either Vice City or in some kind of tropical location. I mean, just look at this supposed introduction featuring the logo. Looks very familiar, huh? And then check out this gameplay screenshot. This picture was revealed with the one that was of the supposed introduction. And I just love how the logo screenshot was taken clearly, but of course gameplay's gotta be blurry, like if the person taking this couldn't hold a camera straight. And it's totally not trying to hide the fact that this is probably a real picture of Bishop Square in downtown Honolulu. Although you definitely can't hide the fact that the protagonist's outfit is kinda weird. Army green pants with a light blue and pink jacket? And considering the fact that even though it kinda looks like Vice City, it's actually Honolulu, was the person behind this trying to imply that it was actually Honolulu? Or maybe the person behind this thought that they would trick people into thinking it was Vice City again, since the setting at least looks like it might somewhat resemble downtown Miami. I mean, look, if I didn't already know this was Honolulu, I'd probably think it was a picture of somewhere in downtown Miami too. This article from 2011 that was written about these screenshots seems to think that it's Vice City as well. I'll give them this at least, they did write an update afterwards and acknowledge that the screenshots were fake. Now going back to the fact that this is a picture of Honolulu, I gotta say, I think a GTA in Hawaii would actually be pretty cool. Especially since the map being an island in the middle of the ocean would finally make sense, but obviously Hawaii is not what we ended up getting for 5. Now, eventually the game was officially revealed, but that didn't stop the leaks or misinterpretations from happening. Someone on YouTube called FranSNK3D began making these 3D animations and referring to them as concepts for GTA 5. Now, this person is obviously a pretty good animator, and I have no idea if they were intending on wanting people to think that this was actually the game, or if they just made these for fun concepts of what they think the game would look like, but either way, a lot of people took it as real footage of GTA 5. And with the exception of this moment where a guy jumps out of a car and, you know, it doesn't look like actual gameplay footage, the animations themselves aren't that bad, but it obviously doesn't match the look of the first trailer either. In fact, it's almost hilarious to think that people actually believed this after they were already shown real footage of the game. What's funny is that Rockstar actually acknowledged one of these videos in an asked and answered post. They picked a question with somebody who had linked to it and asked them if they can disclose whether or not this apparent lighting test for GTA 5 was real or fake. And they did say that there will be a non-stop flow of hoaxes, fake footage, and fake screenshots. Then they say that they're not going to confirm or deny anything because, according to them, there's simply too many to do that with, but if you don't hear anything directly from their own website, then it's probably fake. So basically, they're expecting people to not be complete morons who just believe everything they read off the internet. Or maybe they think it's funny watching how far some fakes can go. Now, whether this person actually intended on tricking people or not, at least they actually bothered to make their own animations. Other people just took footage from a canceled game called 8 Days and tried to claim that that was GTA 5. And you would not believe how many people thought this was actually footage as well. Honestly, it doesn't feel much like GTA either, to me at least, but then I suppose everybody thought that Rockstar was really gonna change things up with 5. I'll say this too, 8 days looked like it would have been fun, and it's a shame that Sony canceled it, but it's also a shame that people bothered to misconstrue this and pass it off as footage of GTA 5, for who knows what reason. Attention? Or just to say they could easily trick loads of people into thinking it's footage of GTA 5? The funny thing is, people didn't stop using this 8 days video because after GTA 5 came out, suddenly this became footage of Agent. Because this totally looks like something set in the 1970s in the middle of the Cold War. And now that Agent is basically a dead project, I wouldn't be surprised if someone even tried to pass this off as footage of GTA 6, just because. Once GTA 6 does come out, I guarantee you someone's probably gonna say this is leaked footage of Bully 2. Jimmy's back, and this time, he's out for blood. Bully 2. This time it's personal. Other fake screenshots eventually began to surface online, and what I find impressive is how, unlike GTA 4's fake screenshots, which mostly came before the official reveal on March 29th, 2007, much of the fake content we saw for GTA 5 came after we already knew what the game looked like. Many of these even came after the great information drought of 2012, when we basically heard nothing from Rockstar for almost a year, with the exception of a couple of screenshots revealed in an article about Max Payne 3. I mean, this fake screenshot was obviously made when we already knew who Trevor was, and I gotta say, this one might actually be a more impressive fake. This was obviously after the Game Informer preview from November of 2012, when we knew that the game was gonna have rectangular radar. Less impressive is this screenshot, which I'm gonna assume is of a Burger Shot warehouse. Or this screenshot, which appears to use elements from GTA 4, since those are GTA 4 pedestrians, and featuring Ray Liotta? This does make me miss the circular radar, though, I gotta say. I hope GTA 6 goes back to this style. Don't ask me why, it's just better. Here's another one with the square radar again, but this time with footage of Alan Wake during one of the driving sequences in that game. Sadly, you can easily tell that this is not GTA 5, just because that's too many trees. Now, let's talk about maps. This is the map that we got, but this is the map that someone thought we might have been getting. I mean, design-wise, I guess it's not bad, but it should come off as an obvious fake. No way the game was ever going to be this big. It looks like a real satellite picture that they stuck into Photoshop and then took a picture of their screen displaying that and then went crazy posting on forums and sending it to blogs. Anyone could easily do the same thing. I'm not an animator or a 3D artist, so while I wouldn't be able to create fakes like this, or even this, if I wanted to, I could just recreate this image to the best of my abilities. See? Keeping up with the fake maps, check out this one. This came with the Ray Liotta screenshot, and it showed us the supposed leaked map of GTA 5. You know, I gotta say, this one's actually not the worst thing that I've seen. I'm guessing they made several very good educated guesses in terms of the placement of locations such as the Alamo Sea and Polito Bay, even though the town I guess they figured Polito Bay was isn't coastal in this. Plus, if you look at this image that they shared, which shows the map zoomed in on Los Santos, it becomes quite clear that this is probably just fan-made. The street layout looks kinda random and it kinda has that San Andreas look to it. It's very 3D era looking. In fact, it might just be a heavily photoshopped version of the Los Santos map from GTA San Andreas. But still, I like how they even predicted that the east part of the city would just be this empty area with a bunch of dirt roads running through it, and their version of the Salton Sea, which is known as the Alamo Sea in game, is located to the north of the city, as opposed to the south of Los Angeles like in real life. And that's actually one thing I never quite understood, because it's also closer to San Diego in real life than it is to LA. Not only that, but there's two things that, believe it or not, I actually like about this. And even though it was shared as just a false rumor and probably got some people's hopes up that this would be the map of GTA 5, there's still a couple of cool things about it. For one, I like that they included another island west of the city. Going by its shape and proximity to the city, I'm gonna guess that this is most likely Santa Catalina Island. Something like this would have honestly been a welcome addition to the map of GTA 5. It's not exactly like a desolate island. There are two towns on it, two harbors, which is tiny, and Avalon, where everybody seems to drive golf carts. A place like this could have added a bit more variety to the map, and I thought it would have been nice to have a place that felt somewhat more remote compared to the rest of the map, considering how I thought the countryside that was in the game already didn't feel much like the middle of nowhere. It seemed like you were always way too close to civilization. The next thing that I actually like about this map is that the highway that's based on the Pacific Coast Highway doesn't just stretch around the entire map in a circle before you end up back in the city. I just felt like being able to easily circle around the entire map just made it too easy to drive around the whole thing, and it made it feel smaller than San Andreas despite being a much bigger map. Plus, it didn't give us as the players much incentive to explore some of the extra countryside we got. Rather than going through it, you would just be able to easily go around it and avoid all of it. The map just cuts off in an almost straight line, kind of like how San Andreas did it, but honestly, I feel like this is a better way of handling it. You can at least judge that the area is probably connected to the rest of the state from there, but southern San Andreas in 5 felt like it might as well have just been another Hawaiian island. Okay, you know what? Why am I praising this thing? Oh, screw this, let's look at one more map that also uses the GTA 4 style menu. A better style of menu, I might add, but definitely not a better style of map on this one. I mean, jeez. At least you could tell whoever made that previous map knew the layout of the LA area. But then, I don't know if the person who made this ever looked at a map of LA. They've given it a bay, east and south facing beaches. Strangely, not a lot of countryside included. It kinda sorta reminds me of San Diego, but then you could just as easily say that it's not even based on anything in California. Oh, and nice fake box art too. I like the random screenshots from the trailer with a Photoshop filter added over them, but I'm gonna have to dock a few points for not including a helicopter in the top left corner, and for using this font on the side of the case instead of price down. But I'll give them points again for having a back with zero description. If IKEA designed a video game box art, this is what it'd look like. Because who needs words when we could just have pretty pictures to look at?